Bon dia! So, this week's topic is a long overdue topic. It's partying in Floripa. Because basically, partying in Floripa, it's got a lot of elements to it. There are different types, there are different places, and there are different kind of ways of approaching clubbing here. And going out in general, because I say clubbing, it's going out in general and partying in general. There are different places, I've already said that, and the lifts will go on. I thought it's about high time that I give you like the pros and cons of going to different places, what is on offer, and kind of how people, Brazilian youth as it were, or just Brazilians in general, how they play it when they go out. So, UFSC parties. That's UFSC, as in Universidade Federal de Santa Catarina. That's the university we're currently going to. They basically have their own parties every weekend or so, or every other weekend. Especially at the beginning of term, you will hear about them having a party, and I say hear about them because you won't be able to get to sleep at night because of the music. And they can go on for as long, for like about 2 o'clock in the afternoon, 8 o'clock in the evening, as long as, for example, 2 a.m., 3 a.m., and sometimes 11 o'clock at night as well. And what are these like? Well, basically, we were originally told that these parties were, quote, epic. And unfortunately, I would say they are not brilliant, unless you are a local and you've already known people for your entire life, or you go to school with them every day. Because UFSC parties aren't literally, you go there, combine a couple of drinks, there's a dance area, or there's not a dance area, it's just basically a bar, kind of made up bar, where you can go buy your coupons, go get your drink, and then you're kind of stood around. There is music, but you have to find your group of friends to stand around with. For us, we obviously made some friends with some travellers, so we kind of stood around and got to know them. UFSC parties, we're not keen on them, basically. We're not keen on them so far. Then you have Lagoa. That's Lagoa de Conceição, Barra da Lagoa, all that region. They have their own parties and things like that. And this is where we've found Casa de Noca, which is where we had our first Batucada night, where they had the drums and they had the live bands and things like that. And then we had the actual Batucada event at the surf hostel. And Lagoa is where you find all the touristy things. It's kind of sad, really. You have to go out your way or go to Lagoa, slash live in Lagoa, to be able to find all the typical Brazilian music styles. That's samba, batucada, sertanejo, forró. This you will all find in Lagoa, basically. And I'm hoping I'm saying this right. But that's what I found so far, basically. It's brilliant fun, because Lagoa is right on the beach, or you know, you've got little shores you can sit on and what have you. But again, you do have to think about taxis, and although they're easy to get, it's still a good like 30 reais to get back to Carapueira, which okay, when you split it's fine, but again, you've got to make the effort to get back over the hill, because you're not going to walk it. You are not going to walk it if you live in Córrego Grande, Carapueira, or Trindade, or even the Centro. Oh, and also you've got to get the buses out as well, or like, basically you're essentially getting 1, 2, possibly 3 buses. So yeah, that's another thing to look out for, really. There's also Irish pub also in Lagoa. Stay tuned for a couple of updates next week when we go to it. It's called Black Swan, and apparently they do cider and Sunday roasts. And I'm not saying that I actually crave a Sunday roast or a cider, but hey, I'm here. I haven't been to an Irish pub abroad, so I'm gonna give it a go. Then you have going out in the Centro, which is kind of your standard clubbing, where all the nightclubs are, and where all the American / British music is played, rock music is played, all of that. There are rock and roll clubs in Lagoa, but for your standard going and just rocking out to a DJ set kind of style music, you go to the Centro. Prices to get in are about 18 reais to get in, and that's about £6. And you have to make sure you pay when you go out. You get given a ticket on your way in, and you just have to pay at the bar before you go out, like, and they won't let you out until you have paid it. So make sure you've got your cash card, whatever you need to pay. So far I've only been to one night out in Centro, and I don't know, it was fun at the time, because it was my first week here, so it's something that I knew, but personally, I don't really like their DJ set here. Oh, and also you've got to make sure you get taxis back then. We have got friends who have walked back before, but it took them an hour because, again, Centroi is like over a hill or through a tunnel and it's not a direct route back. And then you've got your kind of standard bars. So we've got one by us, which is CSSC, Centro Social de Cerveja, which is essentially the central social centre for beer. Very typical student kind of bar name. And that's where we've been a couple of times. I haven't been there for about a month and a half, actually. But it's really wonderful. They do offers every day on different things. Caipirinhas, sushi, pizza, and then beer as well. Each, like, 7 days of the week. And they've all got a different offer at a different time. I think on mojitos as well. And that's a really lovely place to go. It opens till 12, I think, on a weekday, and then 1 or 2 on the weekend. And that's a really nice place to go, whether you're just hanging out and having a couple of quiet drinks, or if you want to go for pre-drinks just before you go out. It's a really social place, and it's really funny. You have to make sure when you go in, you give them your name, and then they write down your name on this little slip, which is basically what you keep with you for the whole night, and it just tops up your drinks or food list, whatever you're having. And then you go to the bar at the end, you pay, they stamp it and what have you, and then you have to show it on your way out. And if you haven't got your bit of paper, or you've lost it, or you haven't paid, whatever, then they won't let you out. It's a really funny system. But it's a great place to go. And there are other bars that you've been to, which literally, you've got the university, and then just on the other side is that there's a strip of bars. Like, again, they're really cool. One's called Meu Escritorio, my desk. And there's a couple of other ones that are just really nice, and they're all out in the open, which are really nice to go and kind of sit and chill in. They've also got their kind of meal parties, where we get invited to our landlady's house at least once a week for churrasco or food or breakfast, like after a night out. She's really lovely. She lets us into her home and just feeds us like at least once a week. It's brilliant. And again, this is another way of like their partying, I guess, because like they'll have a churrasco and then they'll have like someone will have a guitar that they'll just suddenly whip out and start playing. But everyone's just kind of coming together, people from the apartment, you meet some people, you have a chat, you have a laugh, you have like a couple of glasses of wine. It's all very, very sociable. You don't get drunk. It's so lovely. And to be fair, I'm definitely warming to that a lot. Yeah. We've also had our kind of own house party kind of things. I say house party, it's just been gatherings, but it's been about 6 or 7 of us having a couple of drinks and just having a laugh, which has been just as enjoyable as going out to a pub or bar. And yeah, I don't know, my favourite would probably be La Goa, only because I love the beach and it's nice to be properly feeling like you're abroad, instead of Centro, which is just like any other kind of city, really. So summed up, you've got the La Goa for live music and Brazilian music, like you really want your proper Brazilian music. You've got Centro if you're looking for the clubbing scene, or you're looking for American music, or you're looking for something a little bit more dance, techno, electronic, or rock and roll. And then you've got the bars if you're not clubbing slash going out person and you literally can't stay out past midnight, which is fair enough, and you're looking for a quiet night in. So that's partying summed up in Floripa. I'm going to leave you with some highlights from our little nights in slash going out, because I love you guys and you want a taste. So, hope you enjoy.
Never. actually know, like, how to actually do this.
Não gosta?
Te deixa triste, te traz recordação.
Que triste!
Você lembra de alguém?
Atomic energy, 'cause none of them are gonna stop the time.